Being fluent in English, that's the goal. But many English learners study and study and study, but they never reach fluency. Why not? Let me tell you about an invisible fluency killer that affects lots of English learners, and I'll also teach you how you can avoid it. I once had a student who I'll call Pedro, not his real name. Pedro had studied English for many years, both in school and as an adult. He often got near perfect scores on grammar tests, and he knew a lot of words. He could read high-level texts in English. But he couldn't speak, and when it was time to write, he would freeze because he was afraid of making mistakes. So the killer mistake that Pedro made was he learned a lot about English, but he hadn't learned to use English. He knew the grammar rules, he knew the vocabulary, but he couldn't use English at all, and so he wasn't fluent, even though he had studied for many years. That's a lot of wasted time. When you learn a language, there are two components, input and output. Input is what you take in, the textbooks you read, the videos you watch, the podcasts you listen to, the courses you take, teachers who explain things to you. And output is what you produce in English, your own speaking, your own writing. If you only have input and you never practice output, it destroys your fluency because you're only learning about English, not learning to use English yourself. So today's key tip is make sure you balance input and output. How? Here are some suggestions. Every time you learn new vocabulary, go ahead and write your own sentences with those words. Every time you listen to a teacher, try repeating after him or her to practice your pronunciation. Every time you study a grammar structure, use it yourself in at least 10 phrases. And if you can get feedback on your output, someone to tell you if you're doing it correctly or incorrectly, that will improve your fluency even faster. That's why many of the courses in my complete program include homework that helps you use the English you're learning. We have short answer questions in the Vocabulary Builder courses, Phrasal Verbs course, Idioms course, and Advanced Vocabulary and Collocations course. We have recorded speaking tasks in the Everyday English Speaking courses, and pronunciation evaluations in the Pronunciation course and the Shadowing course. And we also have writing tasks in the Advanced Grammar course and Reading course. Like I said, you can send us your homework to get comments from our teaching team. Many students say this personalized feedback is the best part of the courses. So, are you interested in both learning and practicing your English with feedback from a teacher? Click on the link in the video description to learn more about our complete program, which includes homework and feedback. And now you know how to avoid the fluency killer of too much input and not enough output. Make sure you avoid it.